Even Auckland Mayor Phil Goff is calling for the government to change the law around freedom camping. The current legislation allows freedom camping except for areas prohibited by councils. But the Mayor thinks it'll work better if it's flipped on its head to ban freedom camping everywhere except for areas where councils specifically allow for it. Here to join us now is Auckland Mayor Phil Goff to explain why.
Good morning, Daniel.
Good morning. Morena. Good morning. Morena. Why?
Basically, the government, I think, way back in 2011, at the time of the Rugby World Cup, passed legislation in a bit of a rush, and they said the presumption was you could camp anywhere except where it's explicitly prohibited. Right. Now, we've got to turn that into a local bylaw, and our hearing panel has gone out and consulted with the wider community around which are the areas we should prohibit. And the list is probably about 400 different areas. But what the community has come back to us and said quite clearly is, actually, we don't think that it's very appropriate to have people freedom camping within the urban area. You know, you've got reserves all around the city, but is it good to have people out there, you know, with their caravan home, they're washing out just across the fence from somebody that's living there permanently? Right. And the message they've given us pretty loud and clear is they'd pretty much like it to be the opposite way around, and I agree. We need to provide for freedom camping, although, you know, where there are camping grounds, you'd expect people, they're not expensive, you'd expect people to stay there. But to make provision for maybe a dozen sites or a score of sites in the vicinity of Auckland, rather than saying, hey, it's open slather, you can go anywhere unless we have specifically prohibited it, I think is what the public wants, and I think what makes sense. So that's what I've written the letter to the minister is around.
Phil, my concern would be the homeless people who live in their cars. Will this, or how will this impact?
It won't impact on them. You're talking about two different categories of people. The freedom camper is a person, and I've done freedom camping myself overseas, is the person that chooses to sleep in a place on the side of the road as part of a holiday and an adventure. Right. The person sleeping in a car because they're homeless, they're not there as a matter of choice. They're there because they have limited alternatives. And what our position is with our council officers, if you find people sleeping in cars, we're not about to slap an infringement notice on them. What we're about to do is to go to them and say, let's connect you up with our social authorities, our social agencies, to find a permanent solution to your problem. So we need to deal with those two categories of people in a totally different way.
How easy is it to make the changes?
For the government, well, they could probably just withdraw the existing legislation. It's not their legislation, it was the legislation from a previous government. But this is not just a problem that Auckland Council has found.
Is it just an Auckland problem?
No, we've said right across the South Island, people are saying, look, there are more and more tourists coming to New Zealand, and we welcome that, but we also want to preserve our environment, and most freedom campers are probably responsible, some are grossly irresponsible, but they're saying we want a more limited way in which freedom campers can camp, and it would be better to have specific areas rather than to say open slather unless it's prohibited.
What do you say to those responsible freedom campers, though? Are you tarnishing them with the brush that obviously affects the bad?
No, because there are a lot of Kiwis that are doing freedom camping as well, and a lot of us did it in our younger days all around Europe. And, you know, I'd like to think that we were pretty responsible in how we behaved towards our environment. But we also know that there are cases where people aren't responsible in that way. And we need to have more limited areas where they are staying so that we can exercise oversight over them. We don't have an army of inspectors to enforce bylaws. Therefore, you know, having people in a narrower set of spaces rather than a wider set of spaces would make the rules around freedom camping easier to enforce.
So where to now?
I've got to first of all find out what the response is from the three ministers involved. I've written to the Minister of Local Government, the Minister, the Associate Minister for the Environment, and the answer that they give us will tell us how we move forward. If they say, no, we're not going to change the law, then we're going to have to just tighten up the way in which we set the constraints on freedom camping. The one thing we do like about the law is that it does enable infringement notices to be put out. Under the legacy bylaws, you can take a person to court for freedom camping, but it will cost you tens of thousands of dollars to go to court, and by the time you get to court, the freedom camper will have long disappeared. And if the person is still there, you know, the fine would be a couple of hundred dollars. Well, that's not a great use of the ratepayers' money. So we're looking, you know, the infringement notices are a far better thing. On the on-the-spot fine. You can impose it then and collect it then. And just to have that narrower range of places where people can stay, rather than finding that, you know, in your urban reserves around the city, in the city areas, you've suddenly got half a dozen or a dozen camper vans there, people camping in what is essentially an urban area.
Auckland Mayor Phil Goff, thank you for coming in.
Thanks, Daniel.
For your time.